The honor guard from the 171st Air Refueling Wing, Pennsylvania Air National Guard, will post the colors. The national anthem will be sung by Matthew A. Boyce.
Would you please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Lieutenant Colonel Robert D. Boydock, Air National Guard Chaplain, will offer our invocation. Would you kindly bow with me as we pray? Our God and our Father, we acknowledge you as our Creator, Sustainer, and Redeemer. Thus we bow before you now. You always desire the best for your people, so we thank you that you created us with a passion for freedom, and that in every generation you have raised up people who have risked their lives to preserve this value. The men that we honor here today are cut from that mold. They have covered themselves with honor by their devotion to duty and America in the face of great danger. You, Heavenly Father, told us it was a good practice to remember, and so we ask your blessing and dedicate this memorial to those Vietnam veterans who lie in silent graves, no longer fearing the sounds of battle, and also to us as a constant reminder of the cost of our freedom, and to renew our commitment to maintain the peace and freedom we richly enjoy today, ensuring their sacrifices are everlasting. In your wonderful and matchless name, amen. Thank you, Chaplain. It's a pleasure to see so many people here today. Please join with me in a motion of friendship toward your neighbor. Thank you very kindly. Would you please be seated? Diana Williford, past president of Gold Star Mother.
Dear God, please hear our prayer. With majesty, the eagle flies on wings both strong and free, from western mountains capped with ice to Lady Liberty. And my young son gave up his life to help that eagle fly. For democracy and freedom, my child was asked to die. Now all that I have left of him is what my heart recalls. And this gold star a mother wears with a hero's fights and falls. So of our leaders, this I ask, yes, of them I do implore, that never may another die in flaming guns of war. However may the strength in this and never cease, and let her carry in her flight the olive branch of peace.
Thank you, Vina. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the chairman of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Committee, Mr. Todd Ashmore.
I'm going to try to keep this as light as possible. Quite a turnout today. Humbled by the experience of the last 2 years. This started as a very novel idea, and it's transformed. Transformed into a crusade as we made promises to each and every veteran that we met. These promises all had very similar themes. That these men not be forgotten. These are promises that could not be broken. I was 6 years old when the war ended, and I won't forget. More importantly, there now stands a permanent reminder of the sacrifices of all Vietnam veterans. Proof that a lot of people won't forget. You will not be forgotten. As I promised, I'll keep it light. I really wanted to say three things. Personal messages to the each veteran who took today. To those that could not be here. Because we know they're watching. Each and every one of you is a hero to me. And I hold you in very high regard. In my eyes, you walk an inch or two taller than the rest of us. You were one of my primary influences as I grew up, and you're the main reason that I stand here today and say that I'm proud to be an American. And finally, I'd like to say from the very, very bottom of my heart, welcome home.
Thank you, Todd. It is ours in service from all wars. To the left of the memorial, you will notice a table. It is set for four, representing the four major components of our armed forces. Please allow me to explain, as the POW MIA team from the 9/11th Airlift Wing prepares the table. The table is small, symbolizing the frailty of one prisoner alone against his oppressors. Remember, the tablecloth is white, symbolizing the purity of their intention to respond to their country's call to arms. Remember. The single rose displayed in the vase reminds us of the families and loved ones of our comrades in arms who keep faith awaiting their return. Remember. The red ribbon tied so prominently on the vase is reminiscent of the red ribbon worn on the lapel and breasts of thousands who bear witness to their unyielding determination to demand proper accounting of our missing. Remember. A slice of lemon is on the bread plate, reminding us of their bitter fate. Remember. There is salt upon the plates, symbolic of the family's tears as they wait. Remember. The glasses are inverted. They cannot toast with us today. Remember. Chairs are empty. They are not here. Remember. Remember all of us who served with them and called them comrades, who depended on their might and aid and relied upon them. For surely they have not forsaken you. Once again, welcome to our dedication ceremony of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial. Conceived and nurtured by a committee of volunteers who developed the idea, raised the necessary funds, and brought this dream to life. It wasn't an easy chore, but no one ever complained. Washington County lost 67 veterans in the Vietnam War, and this memorial is our way of reminding ourselves that each of those who died in Vietnam should not and must not be forgotten. We are privileged to have as our honored guest today Colonel Retired Walter Joseph Marm, Jr., a veteran of the Vietnam War, a native of Washington, and recipient of the highest decoration bestowed by our country, the Congressional Medal of Honor. At that time, a second lieutenant with the 1st Cavalry Division Air Mobile, Colonel Marm earned the Medal of Honor for conspicuous gallantry at the risk of life above and beyond the call of duty. His company was moving through the Idrang Valley and came under withering enemy fire until they were forced to take cover. Realizing that his platoon could not hold on very long, and seeing four enemy soldiers moving into his position, he eliminated all four. Then, seeing that his platoon was under intense fire from a concealed machine gun, he deliberately exposed himself to draw its fire, located its position, and attempted to destroy it with an anti-tank weapon. Although inflicting casualties, it did not silence the enemy fire. Quickly and disregarding intense fire directed on him and his platoon, Jomarm charged 30 meters across open ground and hurled grenades into the enemy position, eliminating some of the eight insurgents manning that position. Although severely wounded, when his grenades were expended and armed with only a knife, he continued the momentum of the assault on the position and eliminated the remainder of the enemy, eliminating the fire on his platoon, and broke the enemy assault and rallied his unit to continue toward the accomplishment of their mission. Ladies and gentlemen, I am deeply honored to present to you Medal of Honor recipient and hometown hero, Colonel Retired Walter Joseph Marm, Jr.
Thank you very much for that very, very kind introduction. I'd like to thank each and every one of you for being out here today. This is a tremendous turnout. And each of you, I know, are here for your own special reason, but it's to honor the 67 fallen comrades from this great county of Washington. It's also the same number of counties we have in the state, so that's going to be an easy number to remember, 67. My mother is out in the front row, Dorothy Marm. I'd like to honor her and thank her for coming out here with me. She's 85 years young today. And our other Gold Star mothers, my mother, Dorothy Marm, was almost a Gold Star mother. As my citation said, that bullet entered my... I'm very, very fortunate, and I told Dave Smilak from the reporter that for the grace of God, there go I, an inch or two, one way or the other, and... But you're in God's hands every day. We're in God's hands. This is also a unique day. I was wounded on this day, the 14th of November, 1965. That's 34 long years ago. It was the first major battle of the Vietnam War, where the U.S. forces were opposing North Vietnamese regular army forces. It was called the Battle of I Drang. A lot has been written in, there's been a lot of TV commentaries on this battle. I've never been back there, but some of my men and our leader, General Moore, has been back there to review and to go through the battle a second and third time. He also wrote a book about this action called We Were Soldiers Once and Young. It's a very, very well done book about our early days in the Vietnam War in 1965. I'd like to thank Todd Ashmore and his staff of volunteers for getting the job done. I was impressed at how fast this came together. He just did a super job raising money, planning, organizing, and the end product, a very beautiful monument for our fallen servicemen. Thanks for a job well done. It's just a fitting tribute to these wonderful men. Most of them were patriots who did not make it home. Thank you, moms and dads, for your sacrifice. These men will never be forgotten. From the arrival of the first military troops in Vietnam, way back in about the 17th of September, 1950, until the last American military force was helicoptered off the roof of the U.S. Embassy in Saigon on the 30th of April, 1975. Almost 3.5 million American men and women served in Southeast Asia. It was the longest military conflict in the United States history. About 10% of the 3.5 million were either killed in action, wounded in action, or missing in action. That's about, on the Vietnam Memorial Wall, there's over 58,000 names of our fellow brothers and sisters who were killed in action. 300,004 were wounded in action, and 2,200 missing in action. So that's about 10% of the total force that went over there. Pennsylvania lost 3,132 killed in action. Our best and brightest sons and daughters. American armed forces defeated the North Vietnamese and the Viet Cong in every major battle. We won the war on the battlefield, but we lost the peace because of congressional irresponsibility. Once our troops were out of Vietnam, Congress initiated a total retreat from our military and economic commitments to the South Vietnamese people. They could not defend themselves without our military aid of fuel, ammo, spare parts, weapons, and equipment. These men from Washington County would tell us they are proud to have served, proud of their country, and proud to be Americans. God bless them all. I am honored to have served with them in Vietnam, and I am humbled by their sacrifice. I wish I could have brought them all back alive. They were the best of Washington County, Pennsylvania, and our country. Although I did not know all of the 67, our paths probably crossed on the streets of Washington, at the swimming pool, at the stock car races in Arden Downs, the county fairs, dances, football and baseball games, and all the many things that teenagers did growing up in this great county. John Slesh went to the same high school I went to. Dave Myers played baseball with me out at Washington Park, although he was a much better player than I was. I put him through the U.S. Army Ranger School in Georgia, the toughest school in the Army. He was an outstanding soldier. I attended his funeral. I will always miss him and all the other 60 of our 66 buddies. This will be a healing place for all of us at this memorial. Initially, I tried to forget about the war, but as the armed conflicts continue to flare up around the world, and my own two sons are exposing themselves to these same types of dangers, the painful memories creep back. Old battlefield scenes become vivid when the war dead are remembered as forever young comrades who will never again hug their parents. The sad tear that a veteran eventually sheds is not a sign of weakness. It represents the soul of youth in a confrontation with the ghosts of the past. Servicemen and women, past and present, are very special to me. In addition to the threat of being killed or wounded, soldiers endure miserable living conditions and suffer through the loneliness of missing family, friends, and home. They fought proudly, often demonstrating courage on the battlefield and compassion for the people of Vietnam. None cared about heroism or glory. They just wanted to take care of their buddies. War veterans developed a unique bond and perspective on life. This is best reflected in a soldier's quotation made very, very famous during the Vietnam War, and many of my fellow Vietnam veterans know it well. You have never lived until you have almost died. For those who have fought for it, life has a flavor the protected will never know. This monument is part of the healing process to honor publicly our fallen comrades of the Vietnam War. It is not intended to glorify war, but instead is a necessary reminder that the true cost of protecting freedom is the highest cost, life itself. The soldiers of Napoleon received from him a simple medal inscribed with the name and the battle and the words, "I was there." This is the highest reward of service. The true goal of patriotism is the privilege of saying, I was there. I served. These 67 men were there. They served and died for their country, our country. They are my heroes and patriots of our great country. God bless them, God bless their families, and God bless America. Thank you.
Mount Ashmore removed the shroud to officially dedicate the Washington. Thing once I was.
I believe so. I wrote this song in honor of Gary Layton, and it's dedicated to all those who paid the ultimate price.
Thank you, Kathy. The epitaph, which heads the bronze plate, was composed by a Washington County Vietnam veteran and will be read today by Chaplain Boydock.
The words are written inside your program also. Remember us. We were just kids, the most of us. Not militant, not warriors, certainly not men, but trying just as hard as anyone can imagine to be so. Just ordinary guys like you. And had we made it home, we would be standing where you stand, quiet with the thoughts you think. No different, the same, just guys looking to be home.
Thank you, Chaplain.
Sixty-seven veterans from Washington County gave their lives in Vietnam.
Today we officially recognize those individuals and offer our heartfelt and belated thanks for their sacrifice with the placement of a flag in their memory.
Army Sergeant Alan Robert Ambrogi, Finleyville. Marine Corps Corporal William E. Guzman III, Finleyville. Army Specialist 4th Class J. Wayne Parola, Charleroi. Navy Gunner's Mate, 1st Class Samuel Hoyt Barnett, Washington. Army Specialist, 4th Class Walter Wade Hamilton, 84. Army Lieutenant Colonel Paul John Perico, Monongahela. Army Sergeant Ronald Dale Bilarski, Charleroi. Army Staff Sergeant Charles Lewis Harris, Mariana. Air Force Staff Sergeant Thomas Alfred Preo, Cecil. Army Sergeant Albert Brilla, Cannonsburg. Marine Corps Private Robert Kenneth Heiss, Araya. And Army Corporal John Lewis Riegel, Centerville. Marine Corps Lance Corporal Robert Guy Brown, Finleyville. Army Specialist 5th Class Lemuel Isbell, Charleroi. Army Sergeant First Class James Joseph Riley, Jr., Washington. Marine Corps Corporal Robert Elmer Bryant, Washington. Army First Lieutenant Donald Wayne Jacobs, McDonald. Army Private First Class Charles H. Richards, Jr., Cannonsburg. Marine Corps Private First Class Joseph Leon Byrne, Jr., Roscoe. Army Private First Class George Russell Johnson, Amity. Army Private David Lee Reiser, Washington. Army Specialist Fourth Class Michael William Campos, Burgettstown. Army Sergeant Michael Karpiak, Jr., Richieville. Army Specialist 4th Class John Joseph Rudnick, Denora. Army Private 1st Class Daniel Carl Capitani, McDonald. Army Specialist 4th Class Joseph Reuben Carpy, Cannonsburg. Navy Hospital Corpsman Larry Gordon Salisbury, Washington. Army Master Sergeant Michael Anthony Caputo, Sr. of Richieville. Marine Corps Corporal David Wayne Keenan, Claysville. Army Corporal Thomas Alibok Shipe, Venetia. Navy Hospitalman 3rd Class Andrew Peter Chimay, Scenery Hill. Marine Corps Private 1st Class Harry Kenneth Letshaw, Rhea. Army Private 1st Class Robert Archibald Sikon, Washington. Army Specialist 5th Class James Hamilton Colbert, Fredericktown. Marine Corps Private 1st Class Gary Willard Layton, Washington. Marine Corps Corporal Ray Otis Simons, Jr., Avella. Air Force Staff Sergeant Gerald A. Coyle, Bentleyville. Army Staff Sergeant Thomas Milton Lejeune, Monongahela. Marine Corps Private 1st Class John Daniel Schlesch, Jr., Washington. Army Warrant Officer Edwin Harry Curtis, Stockdale. Army Staff Sergeant Gerald James Lynch, Denora. Marine Corps Corporal Alfred C. Springfield, Jr., Cannonsburg. Army Specialist 4th Class Kenneth George Cushman, Finleyville. Marine Corps Corporal Thomas Richard Matty of Denbo. Marine Corps Staff Sergeant Carl Gorman Taylor of Ella. Navy Hospital Corpsman Dennis Patrick Day, Monongahela. Army Specialist 4th Class David Benjamin Matikowitz, Washington. Army Captain Paul Dean Urquhart, McMurray. Army Staff Sergeant Donald James Fawcett, Monongahela. Army Platoon Sergeant Donald Willis McCammon, West Alexander. Air Force Captain Harold Raymond Vogel, Monongahela. Marine Corps Private First Class Robert Gaylord Findlay, Washington. Air Force First Lieutenant James Arthur McEwen, Washington. Marine Corps Gunnery Sergeant James Robert Waltz, Washington. Army Sergeant Floyd Stephen Geibel, Burgettstown. Marine Corps Lance Corporal Robert Allen McPherson, Cannonsburg. Marine Corps Private First Class Sherman Thomas Washington of Marianna. Army Corporal Terry Lee Gilpin, Marianna. Army Private First Class Joseph James Melnick, Jr., Burgettstown. Marine Corps Corporal Richard Lee Winsheimer, Burgettstown. Marine Corps Corporal George Earl Glenn Jr., Marianna. Army First Lieutenant David Ross Myers, Washington. Marine Corps Private First Class Lawrence Frederick Greer, Strabane. Army Staff Sergeant Lewis James Orison, Burkittstown. Marine Corps Private First Class Charles Lewis Zug, Mount Pleasant. Army Staff Sergeant John Panic of Cole Center.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise for 67 seconds of silence, one for each son of war. This will be followed by a 21-gun salute and the playing of taps. And please remain standing as the honor guard retires the colors.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for attending today's ceremony and for sharing this tribute with us. You are not invited to visit and share your own personal moments at the memorial. Thank you.